नमस्कार, हियर द वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक नाउ अडेज इन ऑल एग्जाम्स दिस टॉपिक जनरली कम्स एमबीओ मैनेजमेंट बाय ऑब्जेक्टिव एमबीओ इज ए पार्ट ऑफ प्लानिंग वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर फंक्शंस ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट इज प्लानिंग ऑर्गेनाइजिंग स्टाफिंग कंट्रोलिंग डिसाइडिंग दिज ऑल आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ द मैनेजमेंट सो प्लानिंग इज द फर्स्ट फंक्शन एंड अंडर द प्लानिंग द टर्मिनोलॉजी हैज नाउ बीन यूज्ड एज एमबीओ मैनेजमेंट बाय ऑब्जेक्टिव एमबीओ इज एन अप्रोच टू प्लानिंग दैट एम्स टू ओवरकम बैरियर्स दैट माइट स्टॉप एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फ्रॉम अचीविंग इट्स ऑब्जेक्टिव्स सो बेसिकली हियर द टारगेट इज डिसाइडेड and the whole organization works behind the target how to achieve the target so setting of the goal by managers and their subordinates working together by specifying the responsibilities and assigning authority for achieving the goal is MBO so MBO is little bit different from the other things what is the difference here decision is taken the goal is decided by managers and the subordinates they are working together they are together specifying the responsibility and assigning the authority for achieving the goal so that is why it has high value so management by objective that this term was coined by Peter Drucker in 1954 so MBO is management model that aims to improve performance of an organization by clearly defining objective that are agreed to by both management and employees so the objective is decided pre-decided and agreed by both management and the employees according to the theory having a say in goal setting and action plan should ensure when there is participation in the decision making process the employee will certainly cooperate for the functioning of the job features of the management by objective its philosophy or system its a system also its philosophy also combined goal setting is there optimum use of resources is there operational and functional aspects are there participation by superior and subordinate already discussed collective decision making process is done multiple responsibilities are there and all inclusive and complete so they all are working for the set target so what is the how this process works first setting of the goal the first point is setting of the goal is by done by both subordinate and superiors then set the aligned employee objective then scrutinize the performance then appraisal of the performance and then reward them so this is the process of MBO what are the advantages and disadvantages it optimizes the utilization of human resources there is better communication fixing of responsibilities there career development is there and make possible efforts planning and control so this way MBO is complete next we'll move to motivation till then keep on revising namaskar